So here is a post installation related one, means what are the settings, what is control panel, like that. This PPT is that one, PowerShell interaction, okay, scheduling tasks, exploring apps, like that. Files, kind of stuff. So here is a Windows 10 architecture. Okay, first of all, we'll see Windows 10 architecture because in your syllabus there is a name like some architecture different thing is there. So for that one, so understanding that and Windows 10 architecture. Normally Linux, when you have a Linux and Unix, you have a kernel, shell architectures that is there. So what about Windows operating system? Is also having a kernel and shell kind of stuff. So how it is look like, you can see in this picture. First one is Windows kernel. What is the kernel duty? Interact with your hardware. Now what is this device drivers will do? Device driver, what is device, like maybe audio device, audio chipset is there, video chipset is there for display purpose, graphic cards are there, other different type of chipsets on your motherboard, okay, USB connections or anything, right? So you have a lot of chipsets in your motherboard, kind of stuff, right? External devices like printers, scanners, so they pen drives, external hard disk. So there are all devices only. So how your system will understand those devices, and how system will understand your system related ones. Okay, so what I am doing here, it is what I'm trying to say is, so your kernel knows how to interact with your hardware, and also there's a lot of devices your operating system may not understand complete your kernel part, complete all the devices. So these drivers also a piece of software. Okay, it is also a software which works with your kernel and interact with your hardware. For example, you want to play a song. What we required, you need a song file, we need a .mp3 file, player is required, like a VLC player or some Winamp player, like that. We need a player is required. That is, both are softwares only, applications only. Song itself, it is in digital code, and your application working. But how to send this song in a computer format to your computer, and how to produce a sound from your speakers? So in middle there is a chipset called a audio chipset is there. Okay, so audio chip will understand your song code, and it will convert into sound, and then it is sent to speakers in electrical wave. So it will send to the speakers, right? But how to interact with that audio chip? Your system, your operating system don't know how to interact with it. So these drivers will help you to do it, how to interact with your audio chipset. So now you are seeing the display on the screen. So how you can able to see through the graphic memory, how to interact with that graphic, either graphic card or maybe through graphic memory of your processor and onboard graphics. So these device drivers will help you to understand it. So each and individual devices having a drivers. Okay, so operating system kernel. Next, services. We already seen services, how to manage the services and all. So there is a services to run an application. It will provide certain environment using a .NET framework, Win32, Windows RT APIs. It provide a platform to interact with your application, to run an application and all. In generally, Windows operating system application run based on Win32.exe is there inside. So Win32 does not mean 32-bit kind of stuff, but Win32 is a general platform to operate your applications. So you are running a Windows application means you are running on a Win32 environment. If application is developed based on .NET framework, we need a .NET framework to run the application. If application is developed, Java based application is there, what we required? JRE, Java runtime environment is required. You have to download Java, so then you can run the Java applications. Okay, like that. So I will tell that API part. This is general one. If in case, like if you see any experience with a virus kind of stuff, it will show Win32 virus kind of stuff. It means the self executable programs or certain programs running like a Windows platform, so they'll create to run those viruses on the Windows platform, they create Win32 type of viruses. Okay, so to run with Windows, so that's it is immediately if it is found some virus, a certain virus, it will show Win32 something like that. Okay, so that is one point, just to I mix the point. So here it is, your operating system kernel means your Windows kernel device drivers interact with the hardware devices, interact with the hardware and hardware devices, or system services provide an environment to run your applications. Okay, desktop application, like you install a VLC player, VMware workstation, or anything, like any application you are installed. Okay, all these things are a desktop applications. Second one is you can build your own application. You can build your own application using universal Windows platform, just like an Android Studio. Just like a Android Studio, you can build your own application. If you build an application, there you have to decide either you have distribute that application through Windows Store running environment, or you want to distribute an application in your .NET framework like that. So next one is Windows Store application, like your Google Store, you have a Windows Store is there. So you can see, this is my Windows Store. You can see a bag like this. So it is in my physical machine. So to normally, like your Android Studio, sorry, Android Store, Play Store is there now. So if you want to install some application, games or anything, what you have to do, you have to give your my Gmail account, and then some are paid version, some are free games available, or applications, you can do it, right? Same thing, you can able to do it here. Okay, so this is a Windows Store. Make sure that you have to put your Microsoft account or Office 365 account. Okay, next one is paid thing, you have to pay. Free, you can able to take it as a free only. So like that. So this is Minecraft, you have to pay. Free games available, applications available, best enterprise applications, gaming, enterprise, productivity, like that it is there, no? So you can see. So Netflix, Dolby Access, iTunes, Spotify Music, okay, Prime Videos, Prime Music, DTS Sounds, Music, Crunch, like Facebook Watch, something is there, here it is, Facebook Watch. Like that you can able to run this whenever you install this application. So to run this application, so it will provide an environment here, that is APIs, application program interface. So that will provide interface to run the Windows Store apps in a machine. So that's it. Okay, this is a your Windows 10 architecture. So we'll go to the specific part of device drivers. So these are the different device drivers, means the device drivers, packages and store. Okay, so I will go to a small explanation. Here it is. What is these device drivers? Will work with your so it will interact. It's work with your kernel to interact with the devices. So there is a certain drivers, like, you know, PNP means plug and play type. What is this plug and play type? You know, when Windows 98 is there, when Windows 98 time and earlier Windows 98 and earlier of Windows 98, okay, Windows 98 and earlier of Windows 98 or Windows XP earlier, Windows XP is earlier, not Windows XP. Okay, so world operating system, you want to connect a color monitor. You want to connect color monitor. Monitor is now everything color. Earlier it is monochrome or a color. Two type of monitors are there. Monochrome works directly. If you want to add a color monitor, you have to install the required drivers. So you will get a floppy disk and you have to install it. If you use standard keyboard means IBM keyboard. Okay, if you are using a standard keyboard, PS/2 keyboard, okay, it works directly. But if you are connecting multimedia keyboard, compulsory you have to install the drivers for that one. If you add a CD writer, if you add a CD writer, you compulsory have to install the drivers. That is worldless, right? Now what happened from the XP onwards, they include certain generic drivers. What they are using, there are from XP onwards, generic generic drivers. It means, you know, what is a generic, like generic medicines also there, right? For example, you have a particular disease and the doctor manufacture, earlier days they will manufacture a medicine for a particular disease, but for a particular person, particular type of person, and they will give the medicine to you. Okay, so that is a particular part. Okay, now it is a common medicines, mostly like you got a fever, give some paracetamol, and you also go having a cold, like you give some Monacef or like that. So generic medicines are there, means it applied for a general public purpose or not specifically manufactured for a particular person or a particular disease part. So overall only there are given, right? So same thing, like these generic drivers are a common drivers. Any type of device can work with a generic drivers if it is compatible with it. Okay, so that is important. Okay, so generic drivers are included with the operating system. Okay, so what happened when you connect a pen drive, you know, Windows 98, if you purchase a pen drive or any USB thing, compulsory you have to buy, you have to take the CD. In earlier days we have a mobile phone, when you connect a cable for data transmission, so compulsory you have to insert the CD, install the drivers, then only data transmission will occur, then you know, only it will understand that USB port, otherwise nothing, no work. Okay, nowadays it is working directly, right? So how it is possible? Plug and play. So connect the device, your system, try to understand what kind of device you are connected, where you are connected, what kind of device you are connected. Okay, where you are connected, we are connected to USB, and what device you are connected, first it will sense it. Once it is senses, okay, once it is senses, it load, it search drivers in the operating system itself, in the system, instead of saying operating system, I'm telling system. Okay, it search the any equivalent drivers are available in the system. Okay, if it is there, then it will install that those drivers or use the drivers to work with the device. For example, I have a printer, I connected a printer. Now once I connect the printer, system search for the first what is the device is connected, which device is connected, what type of device it is, what model it is. So it get that information from the printer only. From the printer only it get the information. That is called plug and play. When you connect it, automatically your system sends what kind of device you are connected, and both will communicate each other first, and how to interact with it. Okay, next, system search for the drivers and load the drivers and work with the device. If in case in our system we don't have a equivalent drivers to work with the device, for example printer, so that printer drivers we don't have in the machine, then you have to install the drivers. Then you have to install the drivers. So download the drivers or from the CD, DVD, whatever it is. Okay, so you have to install the drivers. Once you install the drivers, then system can communicate with the device. Like a printer, you want to take a print, so you must install the printer drivers. There is a scanner, you want to scan the document, but you have to operate with the system. So how to operate with the system? You have to install the drivers for the scanner. So using the drivers, it can able to communicate. So what is these drivers? Drivers are make a communication between device and the system. Okay, it is also a software, it is also a program only. Okay, so then this is about your basically drivers. Drivers in the different extensions are there. Some are like a .dll, .sys, .dll are there. Catalog files with signature, .cat files, .inf files are there. Okay. Drivers run in a kernel mode and access all system resources. Drivers enable interaction between the operating system and hardware. Okay, drivers enable interaction between operating system and hardware. So certain times, like you know, when XP is released and people not like it, but later on an XP service pack to release and slowly people start liking service pack to XP, and people don't want to change that operating system also, they'll start loving it. Okay, why? Because of they don't have to buy anything, lot of CDs available and key is available, and moreover it will take very less space, and you don't need to search for a drivers every time. And the next Windows 7 releases start people loving Windows 7. So when you say Windows 10, even still till date, people said Windows 7 is the best one, Windows XP is the best one. Okay, so they don't believe in Windows 10. But guys, remember, when you purchase a new system, like you purchase a laptop, fresh new laptop, you purchase it and you want to install Windows 7, that is stupidity, because of Windows 7 don't understand a new type of hardware chipsets. You don't understand it. Those drivers are not there. Again, you have to install the drivers. All the drivers you have to install it. Okay, so if you take Windows 10, you want to install a latest Windows 10 in your latest Windows PC, in a PC, then what happened? Automatically install the drivers. If you want to cut the budget for a Windows operating system, so use Ubuntu base, then try for a Ubuntu, practice, find out issues like that, you can use it. So you can't able to offer the Windows 10. Otherwise, of course, we have a lot of images available, keys and KMS activators are available, but still better to use a genuine one. First preference is genuine Windows 10 operating system if you are purchasing latest Windows operating Windows machine. Okay, so compatibility is more. Okay, so here it is about the drivers. So this is a device manager to see what are the devices in your system. You can see from there in a device manager. Also you can use PowerShell tools, devcon.exe tool, like that. This is to verify a driver signature. So this is another difference between 32-bit and 64-bit. So we'll go to that one. Okay, so first device drivers. Okay, so then we'll see remaining things. To go to the device manager, there is a different ways to go. One is you can go through the control panel and device manager. So like a control panel, So this is a device manager. Go to device manager. So you can see all the devices listed here. All the devices in the system. Okay, by default system. So what are there? It is there, including like monitor, network adapters, your network adapter. Okay, so if you have a printer, then printer information, processor, everything, USB, universal serial bus, storage, controllers, Bluetooth, batteries, CD, DVD, like that. Okay. Human interface devices like USB or these things, mouse, keyboard, touchscreen, like that. This is separately also given. Okay, so this is a device drivers. Again, I will be back to that one. Another one is same device drivers directly dev mgmt.msc. What it is? Dev mgmt.msc. So this is also directly open device manager. You can go through comp mgmt.msc also. Okay, so because better I have to tell everything. Okay, you want to do a little bit of multiple things, then better is comp mgmt.msc computer management. Otherwise, you can go to this PC, right click, manage. This PC, right click, manage. So, it will open, it will take time. See here it is, this is my PC. This PC, right click, manage, manage. Like this. Okay, this PC, right click, manage. It's opening in background, so it will take time. So this is a computer management. Okay, you can see system tools, task scheduler, event viewer, shared folders. You can see shares, shared folders. You can see the sharing here. What are the things you shared and where is actually location of that one? This is data 2, data 3, share 2, share 3, data 1, data 1. Here share name is single name only, but you can see actually path is maybe different. Okay, number of connections, currently how many people are accessing also you can see. Next, users, local users and computers, users. See your users. Now you want to change, like you can change the password, like you can reset the password from here also. Okay, set password. Or you can go to the properties. Okay, like this it is showing, see properties. Okay, by default is a member of users group, that's it. You can add to other groups also. If you add to the administrators group, automatically is administrator, he become administrator. Okay, this is an administrator. You can see down black arrow, it means it is disabled. If you want to enable this one, you can enable it also. So it is disabled, just unselect the account is disabled. Unselect the account is disabled part, okay. Apply OK, automatically administrator become enabled. Okay, like that. Next, guest. Guest also disabled here currently. Now, for example, what is the guest? Some guest came to your home. You want to use your laptop or desktop. You can't give your account, because if you give account, he will do everything. He can see everything. Okay, he is maybe try to do something, right? Like installation settings, or maybe you can manipulate something. So if you enable the guest, and you can give guest user account, so you can open the system. Maybe you can open the browser, sending a mail, receiving a mail, maybe one or two files. That's it. Not more than that one. So guest is a temporary person, right? So guest has a guest related access only. Guest cannot question you, cannot access everything in a home, right? Just in a limitation. So like that. You can enable it by like this. Apply OK. Guest can be enabled. Anyway, we are here. So I'm going to tell you how to create a user. You can create a user from here also. Computer management, local users and groups, users. You can see new user. This is very simple to create a user. User, username. So student 3. Full name, if you want, you can give. Otherwise, it's okay. Student 3, Vedic. Description something. Password. You know, can give password or not, no problem. So unselect this one and leave like that only. Okay, otherwise you can change these things. If you select this one, account will be disabled. You can select this one and this one, that is your wish completely. But read it, password never expiry, by default password. Next one is user cannot change the password. So like that, if you user want to change the password, you can. But I'm not giving any password here. Just create, close. So I created another user also like this. Okay, already I have a student 1 and we created student 2. Now we created a student 3. Okay. You can make them as an administrator by adding user 2 like this. Member of add administrators group. So one second. So by groups, you can find here, find now, administrators group. Okay. Okay. Now this user 3 become a administrator. So we'll see how it is. Now he's a member of administrators group. So then you can see like he's an administrator. These are the groups, different groups are there for different roles. These are local groups. Local groups like Hyper-V administrator group. Member of Hyper-V administrators group can manage Hyper-V. Power users, remote desktop users, like that. This is performance. I'm just try to explain everything. Of course, this is a performance monitoring, open resource monitor. Okay, and also you can observe a particular application or a particular thing, like a only network, only particular process, like that. Also we can able to monitor and we can collect the data and we can create a reports and send the reports to remote PC. Okay, so most of, like, you don't need to go for a lot of tools to do it. Just you can go through this regular tools. Okay, next, device manager. So I didn't explain what is a task scheduler and the event viewer. So task scheduler is, you can schedule a task, means like a take a backup, okay, or maybe a shutdown, or maybe update, like that. You can schedule a certain task in a certain period of time, like a regular interval of time, every 1 hour, every day, every month, every week, like that. You can able to schedule the task like a cron tab. Okay, event viewer, will back to the event viewer. So compulsory event viewer is important. This is a disk management, you know already. And next one is service management. Okay, so this is a disk management. Okay, and this is a service management. Already we seen service management. Okay, managing the services. So finally, this is a device manager. You can manage the devices from here. So to go to, if you want to add a user, you want to set the password for a user, or maybe you want to manage your disk, managing services, managing device drive, device management, event management, task scheduling, okay, share folders. So you can go to computer management. You can go to computer management, compmgmt.msc, like that. Of course, we'll go to device manager. Only device manager. How to manage the device, we'll see. Then only we'll go to other things. Already I explained a plug and play. So when you add a device, automatically it will sense what kind of device. And also generic drivers will try to install the drivers required for the machine. Okay. So here you can see Bluetooth device like that, batteries. Network adapter is the best way to understand. So when you add a new device, you added a device, but plug and play is not working. It's not sensing. It's not throwing error or anything is there. So better click on your computer name in the top. Scan for hardware changes. It is forces to check your system. Any new devices added, like you connected a printer or a scanner or something devices. You connected it, but it is not showing anything on your system. So what to do? Right click, scan for a hardware changes. Any new thing is changed or added. Okay, scan for changes. Actually, it should show adding a device part, but not really showing. I'm in a student one only. Next, just for example to explain, I'm taking network adapters. This is a our network adapter in this virtual machine. So right click, can you see update drivers? Maybe network adapter not working properly. Maybe drivers are available. You can update drivers manually. You can disable the devices. Device is not working or not required to work. Okay, so you can disable the devices. You can uninstall the device. Okay, you can uninstall the device, means you're uninstalling the drivers for it, so then automatically the devices won't work. For example, your network drive or maybe a printer or maybe some device is not working properly. What to do? Uninstall the driver, restart the machine. Very simple. So you think drivers may corrupted, driver some issue is there. Because of that one device is not working, then what to do? Uninstall the device, uninstall it and restart it. Restart the system. Automatically it will sense the drivers. So it reload from the previous one. Scan for hardware changes. Any changes occur, so you can scan it. So I'm going to properties. Properties. This is working properly showing. Sometimes it shows code 10, code 20 like that. It depends upon device working on that. I'm directly going to drivers. Okay, so drivers tab, you can see digital signature, version, date, provider, like that. It is provided by Microsoft only, because Microsoft and VMware collaboration. Normally devices may be manufactured from different organizations like a Realtek, Qualcomm, like that. Okay, so check the driver's date and version, so whether it is latest one or very old one. So if you want, you can update the drivers. This is the driver details, where is your drivers are located. See Windows system 32 drivers and some name dot sys. So that is the location of the drivers. See Windows system 32 drivers folder contain device drivers files. Dot sys files. So next one is updating drivers. So you can update your drivers manually or a automatic format, like update drivers. search automatically, like within your system, you already having a drivers, it will search it and it will load the drivers. This is you have to tell where the drivers are available in your system, okay, manual. Of course, I already told disabled devices and uninstall devices, okay, so that is like if you have any issues based on that, we can do it. Uninstall, usually like drivers are not working, that drivers are blocking some work, so you can disable it. If drivers are not working properly, device is not working properly due to the drivers, so uninstall it, restart the machine, and then automatically it is reinstalled. Only one option is left, that is called a rollback drivers. What is rollback drivers? You install a drivers, now it is working, the device is working fine. Now you find new version of the drivers, new version of the drivers, okay, you find it. Now install the new version. Now new version is not working, understand? Earlier it is working, old one is working good, but you find the new one, you install the new one, it's supposed to function good, but instead of functioning good, so it is working, instead of functioning good, what happening? It is not working now. So what to do? Rollback drivers. Remember, rollback drivers means if the device fail after updating the driver, roll back to the previous installed drivers. You can able to go to previous one, rollback drivers, go to the previous one, working one. So then your system start, means your device start working properly. Okay, there may be a problem with the updates. One option is there, that is called digital signature. So, digital signature Microsoft. Already I told, 64-bit compulsory, each and every device digitally signed drivers, you have to use it. What is digitally signed? This is Microsoft Windows operating system. Device can be anyone, right? From Realtek, maybe from Qualcomm, maybe from Gigabyte, maybe from Gigabyte, right? So like that, different devices manufacturers are there. So what this they will do after manufacturing of a device, so they will also manufacturing a drivers. After manufacturing a device like a maybe a pen drive or maybe network adapter, NIC adapter, this is NIC, right? So network adapter, maybe audio chip, maybe a graphic card, maybe a audio chip, maybe a graphic card, okay? So maybe it is a audio chip or maybe a graphic card. So here it is, once they are manufacturing MSI, take MSI an example, MSI graphic card, I am using MSI graphic card. So once the manufacturer device, they also give you drivers, but those drivers should be digitally signed by Microsoft. So Microsoft give authorize these devices, these drivers are genuine, it is works for Windows operating system, no issues are there, so it won't, okay, like that. So that is digital signature make genuinity of drivers. You know, some people will download a drivers from third party tools, magic drivers, you know, there is a CD called magic drivers, okay, like that applications are there. So there are third party drivers, sometimes digital signature is missing. Okay, if no digital signature, 64-bit PCs throw an error, it won't work with the 64-bit PCs. 32-bit will show warning, but it ignore it, so it won't block it. But 64 compulsory digital signature is required. What is digital signature? Approved by Microsoft, the drivers approved by Microsoft, which is manufactured, which is made it from the manufacturer of a particular device. Okay, rollback drivers, update drivers, disable drivers, uninstall the drivers. So this is about your device management. If you want to add a device, right click, it is not showing adding a device, so we'll see that one. If you want to add a device, directly I can add it from there, or you can go to control panel. just a control panel option only, or you can type it in search box also. Devices and printers, just click on devices and printers. Okay, so if you have a printer, then you can directly tell add a printer, add a printer. If you have a printer, if you don't have, your device is not printer, it is device is something different one. Okay, add a device, like see. So it is searching which device you are connected. Okay, it is searching which devices you are connected. So yeah, I said not finding what you're looking for. I click on that one. Now it is showing something in my, as per my PC, Bluetooth, headset, line, like that. Like you want to add a Bluetooth or anything, so you can try from here. Okay. Okay, so you can add it manually or automatically it will detect. So this is about your device drivers. Next part we'll see directly how to add a printer or how to install a printer kind of stuff. Yeah, here it is open. Event management is also very important. What's the time?